Hello students, so today we are going to see Ampere's circuital law. What is this Ampere's circuital law? Similar to the Gauss law, where Gauss law is a special case of your Coulomb's law, here Ampere's circuit law is a special case of your Weitz-Sauer's law. So the Ampere's circuit law states that the line integral of tangential component of H, that is magnetic field intensity, around a closed path is the same as a net current I enclosed by the path. It is nothing but that is of closed integral of closed line integration of H dot dl is equal to I enclosed. So this is your Ampere's circuit law. So what it is telling, like the magnetic field intensity enclosed by the closed path is equal to the current enclosed by the same path. This Ampere's law is similar to the Gauss law and it is easily applied to determine magnetic field intensity when the current distribution is symmetrical. It should be noted that the equation integration over H dot dl, which is equal to I enclosed, is always holds whether the current distribution is symmetrical or not. But we can use the equation to determine capital H. So let us consider this. I enclosed is equal to the line integration of H dot dl. By using Stokes theorem, this H dot dl can be written as the surface integration of del cross H into ds. By using Stokes theorem, line integration of H dot dl is equal to del cross H, that is curl of the magnetic field intensity into ds. But according to the continuity theorem, this I can be written as I is equal to the surface integration of J dot ds. Surface integration of J dot ds. So in a place of I, can I write this J dot ds? So by considering this J dot ds, so finally we can write the surface integration of del cross H is equal to del cross H into ds is equal to the surface integration of J dot ds. So if you compare LHS and RHS part, so in a place of del cross H, here we have ds. So finally we can write del cross H is equal to J. This is the one of the Maxwell's equation. So let us summarize all Maxwell's equations after completion of your magnetic flux density and magnetic flux. Let us see some applications of this Ampere circuital law. This Ampere circuital law finds application. Application in the first one is infinite line current. So we now apply Ampere circuit law to determine magnetic field intensity for some symmetrical current distributions as we did for Gauss law. So we will consider an infinite line current and infinite sheet current and infinite long coaxial transmission cable. So infinite line current second one is infinite sheet current and infinite long coaxial transmission line. Let us consider infinite line current. So Let us consider one conductor which is having the infinite length. So its magnetic field intensity will be encircled about the conductor. So the direction of the magnetic field will be given by your right hand thumb rule. So let us consider this is your z axis and this is your some y axis and this is your x axis. And this is your length of the conductor, which is infinite length. Then the magnetic field will be like this around the conductor. So this path is called as Amperian path. This path is called as Amperian path. So here we have considered infinitely long filamentary current which is carrying. So here we have placed one infinite long current carrying conductor on z axis, which is defined from minus infinity to plus infinity and which is carrying a current of I. So this is carrying a current of I along the z axis, which is shown in this figure. To determine magnetic field intensity at a point, that is, let us consider this is a point. I want to find the magnetic field intensity at this point P. This is called as observation point. We allow a closed path through the P because, why we have considered the closed path? Because according to the right hand thumb rule, the magnetic field intensity will be encircled by the conductor. So this path which Ampere's law is applied, so we are going to apply Ampere's law to this path. So that's why this path is called as Amperian path, which is analogous to the Gaussian surface. We choose a concentric circle. This is called as a concentric circle as a Amperian path in view of that Ampere, that is your Ampere's circuital law. So which shows that magnetic field intensity is constant provided by rho as a constant. So let us consider this is a rho is a, so rho is a from this point to this point, that is your radius of this circle. And since this path encloses whole current I according to the Ampere's law. So according to the Ampere's law, what it is telling? According to Ampere's law, the magnetic field enclosed by the closed path, which should be equal to your same as the current enclosed by it. So according to the Ampere's circuit law, so I can be written as, that is the closed line integration of H dot dl. The closed line integration of H dot dl. This H can be written as, always H is defined in phi direction. So H phi, the direction of your A phi, dot product with your, what is the dl? Dl is the thing, but some length on this Amperian path dl. This dl is obtained with the help of your cylindrical coordinate system. So dl is nothing but it is the arc length. So this dl is equal to rho into d phi in the direction of a phi, that we have discussed in the first unit, that is your arc length. If I consider this is a one point and this is one more point, this is phi, then this is your arc length. This arc length is equal to rho into d phi, which is in the direction of phi. So if you consider here h phi a phi dot a phi is equal to 1, then the integration of rho into d phi. So here phi is defined from 0 to pi, that is according to cylindrical coordinate system, the phi lies between 0 to 2 pi, that is 0 less than or equal to phi less than or equal to 2 pi. Let us consider the integration over 0 to 2 pi rho outside phi d phi. So d phi becomes your phi. So h phi rho 2 pi. So with this we can write. So finally we can write h is equal to, so here we got I is equal to H phi 2 pi rho, but H is equal to H phi dot A phi. So H phi, this is your H is equal to, that is magnetic field intensity is equal to H phi A phi. So from this we can write H phi is equal to I by 2 pi f 2 pi rho. Let us substitute here. So finally here you will get H is equal to, what is this? This is not a H5, just generally not, it is a multiplication. So H5 A5, H5 is equal to I by 2 pi rho, substitute here, H5 is equal to I by 2 pi, I by 2 pi rho into A5. So this is your magnetic field intensity when infinite length of the line is conductor. So same we have proved with the help of your Bight-Savart's law. So in the Bight-Savart's law, we have considered one case, that is whenever you consider an infinite length conductor by substituting I is equal to I by 4 pi rho cos alpha 2 minus cos alpha 1, where alpha 2 tends to minus 180, that is a 180, and alpha 1 tends to your 0 degrees. By substituting alpha 1 equal to 0 and alpha 2 equal to 180, we got I by 2 pi rho into A5. So in the next class, we are going to see your magnetic flux and magnetic flux density. So after that, we'll summarize all Maxwell's equations. Thank you.